Some of these stages look absolutely amazing, and some of them kind of blah. But there are a few times that you can tell where they tried like a lot more than others to make it look really good, or to make a certain like effect or something on one stage, like on the waterfall we passed earlier, and the water here or the icicles here, even though. Look as good at the slower resolution, but that's what I had to play in, so the hard drive could actually keep up. Because this is transferring a gigantic amount of data or writing. I'll probably have around 30-35 gigs of compressed video just from this alone, which you'll have to re-encode and upload to YouTube.
Checkpoint.
This jungle stage looks really nice too. This is also one of the harder stages, I think. Maybe it just have problems at the end or different points. Also, when you're like power setting or returning the only the positions of the front two tires matter for your actual speed on the road. Which is kind of weird because all these are going to be rear wheel drive cars, I would imagine, but yeah, that's how it goes. So you can basically have the back of the car well off the road. Whoa, I actually dodged the Donald's rocks, usually I hit them. Yeah, on like expert videos, you'll see they're just hugging the lines the entire time, and it's absolutely ridiculous. Like this, but except the entire way through. Yeah, like I said, there still is a community out here, but you'll only pretty much find them on the. On the 360 version of the game now, because like this committed sugar had a server shut down. I doubt the one on the original Xbox still works anymore. And they recently took down the servers for the arcade machine once too. Because that's just how it goes, I guess, these days. There used to be a community on game FAQs, which had a lot of like the regulars, and then they also had a developer there of the company who ported these to pilot systems, Sumo Digital, I believe.
Checkpoint.
So that was nice, but usually it died off once at a time. I think this dude has really nice backgrounds too. These you can probably wash them a lot better than I can, considering that I have to actually drive them down. I'm also getting points for passing all these people, as you can probably see, but you know, points don't really matter. It's a pretty chill run. The floor of Village looks really nice. And I think I have Milky Way soon after that. Oh yeah, I'm playing on the. I don't know if I said this, but I'm playing on the Outrun2SP stages. The original. Okay. These naming conventions are very strange, but. There was first Outrun, and then I think there was another one, like Outrunners or something. Then a long time later, they made Outrun2, which is basically this. That was. The arcade and regular Xbox, and then they made R2SP for the arcade, which had an entirely different set of stages, and then they combined the R2 and R2SP on the Xbox and this game, and added like home mode, which is called Coast2Coast. So they called this game. Outrun2 Coast2Coast, even though it's like a combination of all three. So, and then the like 360 port is named something completely different, like Outrun Live or something. I don't know. So it's just, it's kind of confusing. But that's, nothing's worth. Yeah, this stage is very, very annoying because
checkpoint.
It's split into two parts, and my dog's barking, and both of them are extremely, extremely narrow. Yeah. This is very difficult to go through without crashing at least once, and that is completely messed up. I scratched myself on the wall. But I'm going really slow now, so I can make it. So that's good. And we have one more stage left, which also looks very nice. Oh yeah, also, as you've seen, like, different flying things come up. I have different issues at each stage just based on how I've done in there. I haven't been doing amazingly well or anything, so I've just been getting that random flock. But you can get like, man, these are really close in stage, but you can get like the dragon or paraglider or single birds and I don't remember what else. Also, this stage like helps you with the turning at some points too. It's really weird. It, like, it's an auto turning mechanism. And I think this is about it. So, as we end up at the Statue of Liberty in New York, apparently. Thanks for watching, and this was the first ever playthrough of Outrun2006 Coast2Coast SP Special Edition, whatever it's called.